Good afternoon, everyone. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I swear that thing rings 15 times at noon. Always seems more than 12 to me. Welcome. We're so happy to have you here today for a wonderful concert. Just a few things to mention before we hear Carolyn play. We have two more concerts in the series. Next Thursday, the flutist Agita Arista from Boston will be here to play. Our own David Hines will be accompanying her. She's a wonderful flutist who did a live stream concert during COVID, and it was marvelous, so please come back for that. And then the following week, I believe it's June 2nd, that will be our final concert for this season, and that David and I will be sharing that concert and playing music for the organ. We don't know exactly what yet. That's an added concert to fill out the year, but that will be our concluding concert. Lots going on tonight. At 7 o'clock, there's a free concert. The Marywood University Chamber Singers from Pennsylvania are on tour, and they will be giving a free choral concert tonight at 7 o'clock here at Grace. You're welcome to come back for that. And Sunday at 4 p.m., the Grace Church Choirs will be singing choral evensong with some really great music. That'll be our final evensong for this season, so you're welcome to join us for that as well. And we are always happy to have donations. There's a wonderful little box, wooden box, next to the baptismal font. It says donations for Grace Church, but it is for music at Grace. So anything you put in there goes to sustain this series. And as you may know, we are also working to raise money to restore and rebuild our magnificent, or once magnificent and soon to be magnificent again, we hope, pipe organ. If you can help us to do that, you can speak to me. We're happy to talk to you about how you can make a pledge or a gift to that project. We're in the process of trying to complete a $25,000 challenge grant. If you can help us with that, that would be wonderful and most welcome. We are so happy to have Carolyn Craig here today. Carolyn and I both hail from Tennessee, though she more recently than I. And Carolyn's graduating from Yale University this week, and then is off to, after a busy summer of concerts, off to Westminster Cathedral in London, where she will be the organ scholar in the fall. So we're so happy for Carolyn and for those opportunities. Look forward to hearing this great concert. So please give her a very warm welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It is such a pleasure to be here with you today and an honor to get to share this music with you. Thank you for coming. I'm going to speak just a little bit about the pieces, next about the next two pieces, and then I'll play those two, and then I'll talk about the final two. The next piece is Fauvy's verset on the Tantum Ergo Sacramentum. Fauvy was a professor at Liège Conservatory and was also an accomplished violinist, pianist, composer, and conductor. She especially composed a lot of chamber music. If you will open your hymnals to hymn 329, that is the Pange Lingua Gloriosi. And she bases this piece on the fifth verse of hymn 329. That's the da 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 da. And she just uses the very beginning of that as the basis for her piece. So if you'd like to follow along with that first phrase, in hymn 329 and with the text from stanza 5, that's the basis for this piece, which she dedicated to the memory of her composition teacher. Following that, we'll have Florence Price's finale from Sonata No. 1. As you may know, Florence Price was the first African-American woman to have a piece performed by a major American symphony orchestra. And she was also, you may not know, an incredibly accomplished organist. And she received her artist diploma at NEC, and while she was there, she played this work to Alexandre Guimont. She played Guimont's first sonata to the composer, and years later wrote this work based on his first sonata. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you. We'll finish with pieces by Vierne and Bach. Vierne's Naiads depicts the constant flow of water, which is familiar to us today, and then the embodiment of water nymphs or naiads. And I'll finish the program with Bach's fugue in E flat major. This is often referred to as the St. Anne fugue because it's based, well, it shares a common tune with O God, our help in ages past. And you'll hear that throughout all three sections of this fugue. Bach was also very into numerology, and so the three sections of the fugue are now understood to represent the Trinity. The first section is big and broad, and that's God the Father. And then we have something gentler, that's God the Son. And at the very end, something very fast and in a compound meter, that's typically associated with God the Spirit. So I hope you enjoy Naiads and the St. Anne fugue. Thank you so much.